Okay, so student, now we are going to discuss very important part of the hydrocarbon, and which is type of hydrocarbon on the basis of types of hydrocarbon chain. Okay, like if we have all the carbon-carbon attached in a straight line, then it will be straight chain hydrocarbons. If some secondary carbons have like as a substitution methyl group, then it will be the branch chain we will discuss here in detail, don't worry. And then last but not the least, we have ring chain, or they are also called as closed chain hydrocarbon. So first we're going to discuss about straight chain hydrocarbon. So first type we are going to discuss here, straight chain hydrocarbon.
Sir, okay? Is ring chain and closed chain the same thing as the cycled ones, so cyclobutane and cyclopropane.
Cyclic. Or here also we can write cyclic also. Cyclic hydrocarbons. Okay, they are also called as cyclic hydrocarbon. Understood?
Yes, okay. Sir.
So we will discuss one by one. So first we are going to discuss about straight chain hydrocarbon. Okay, so I'm just making you understand about the primary and secondary, tertiary, quaternary carbon atom like this. So wait a second, this is the extra part. So suppose all the carbon-carbon, okay, present in single bond like this, okay? And here we have hydrogen, is it? So suppose that first carbon, it is attached maximum only with one carbon atom, is it?
Yes.
So if a carbon atom attached with maximum only one other carbon atom, or none means in case of methane, we do not have any carbon atom here. We all have hydrogen. So here we can write none. None means no carbon atom other than the center carbon. But here we have only one carbon atom. Okay. So such carbon atoms are called as primary carbon. They are called as primary carbon. Okay. And those carbon, they are attached with two other carbon atoms. So that carbon, okay, I am making circle, the red circle here, that is attached with here one carbon and this side two carbon, is it?
Yes.
So that carbon atom is attached with maximum two carbon atom are called as secondary carbon. Secondary carbon atom. Okay. Suppose here we have one carbon chain like this. Here we have hydrogen. So can we say here one carbon atom that I am making circle is attached with three other carbon atom, here one, here two, and here three. Then that carbon atom is called as tertiary carbon atom. Tertiary carbon atom. Okay. If sometimes suppose four carbon atoms are attached like this. And here also. So all the side four carbon atoms are attached, then it is called as beta. Quaternary carbon atom. Quaternary carbon atom. So have you understood primary, secondary, tertiary, and quaternary carbon atom? Okay. So here we have definition. So those hydrocarbon having only primary and secondary carbon atom, okay, are called as straight chain hydrocarbon. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So straight chain hydrocarbons means what? So hydrocarbons which have linear structure. Linear or straight line structure.
Sir, what do we have after quaternary hydrocarbon?
No carbon atoms are present after that.
Okay. Yeah.
So hydrocarbons which have linear straight line structure. That means only primary and secondary. Or secondary, we can write also primary or secondary, or both. carbon atoms are present. Okay, or both carbon atoms are present. Carbon atoms are present. Okay, are called as straight line structure. Are called as are called as straight chain hydrocarbon, straight chain hydrocarbon. Understood, everyone? Like here we have propane, CH3, CH2, CH3. We have, this is propane. Okay, here we have butane, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. It is butane. Okay, then we have CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. So it is pentane. Okay, etc. These are the examples. So see here, this is primary carbon. This is secondary, this is secondary, this is secondary, then this is primary. So here we have only primary and secondary, not tertiary. Understood?
Sir, yes, how are you identifying that it's propane, butane or pentane?
So it will make, it will give you only the structure like this. So you have to identify the presence of only primary and secondary carbon, then it is straight chain hydrocarbon. You have to go through that part. Which one? That primary and secondary. You have to identify there. Okay.
So, identifying primary and secondary, how will that help us to identify its butane or pentane?
Number of carbon. One have meth, two have eth, three have prop, four but, etc.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, so just take a screenshot for straight chain hydrocarbon. Done, everyone?
Done, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir. Done.
Okay, now we are going to discuss about the branch chain. Branched chain,
sir, 15 minutes before the class.
Okay, we had to cover that branch as well as quick. Okay, branch chain hydrocarbon. Okay, so in branch chain hydrocarbon, we have carbon, like tertiary carbon, at least one tertiary or quaternary carbon atom will present. Okay, so I'm writing here hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons in which at least one, more than one will also present, possibilities there, but we are discussing about at least one. Okay, at least one tertiary, it is represented by 3 degree, it is tertiary, or quaternary carbon atom. Quaternary carbon atom.
Any one in these both, sir? Any one in these both?
Any one or maybe both. Possibility is there. Okay. Yes, carbon atoms are present. Okay. Then they are called as branch chain hydrocarbon. So we just discussed about straight line here, the butane one. So CH3. CH2, CH2 and CH3 was the butane. So it is straight line. I'm just making it in branch. So its molecular formula is, it is C4 and H, 3 to the 6 and 10, C4H10. I'm just writing here the branch structure for that. So it is CH3, CH, here we have CH3 and again here CH3. See here that carbon is tertiary one. Okay. That means it is branch chain. So here, this is the branching. For pentane, Okay, see, this is the second number carbon. This is a tertiary one, but it is present in second number, is it or not? It is called as beta isobutane. Its name is isobutane. Yes, isobutane.
So what does iso represent?
Iso represents the methyl group or CH3 group. Present one CH3 group, or I'm writing here one CH3 means methyl group present on second number carbon atom. Second carbon atom of hydrocarbon. Second number. Suppose if we have here CH3, CH2, CH, again I'm writing here CH3 and then here CH3. So from this side, we have to choose the minimum distance where substitutions are present. So if you will count from this side, it is carbon number 1, carbon number 2, carbon number 3 and carbon number 4. So here again that methyl group present on second number carbon atom. So it is again isopentane. Isopentane. Understood everyone? So what is iso represents? If methyl group is present on second carbon atom of hydrocarbon are called as isoalkanes. So here we have for 4 carbon butane, for 5 carbon pentane. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So its IUPAC name is 2-methylpropane. It is isobutane, but its IUPAC name, this is a common name. Okay, but its IUPAC name is 2-methylpropane. Its IUPAC name for that compound. And here it is 2-methylbutane. 2-methylbutane. Okay. Again, we have one more example. This is only for iso. Take a screenshot quickly.
Sir?
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be CH3, CH2, CH3, CH3.
Which one?
Isopentane. So yes. 3 CH3s and 1 CH2.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So again, I'm just making another example for neoalkanes. Neoalkanes. See, isoalkanes means only one methyl group is present on second carbon atom, and in neo, 2 carbon atom. Suppose here we have CH3, CH2, and here we have CH3, again here CH3, and here CH3. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So here, this is the first carbon. This is second carbon. So again, on second carbon, we have 2-methyl group. If 2-methyl group are present, then they are called as beta neoalkanes. Okay, so what is the definition for neoalkanes? When 2-methyl group are when present on, yes, on second carbon atom, okay, are called as neoalkanes. So I'm just writing definition here. When 2-methyl group. Methyl group.
Sir, iso means one, right?
Iso means one and neo means two. Methyl yes. group are present. Okay, that means here we have quaternary carbon atom. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, if it is quaternary, then it is neo. Okay? On yes, second sir. Carbon atom.
Sir, will its name be 2,2-dimethylbutane?
Yes. So here we had two substitution. So for the position is only two. So I'm writing here 2,2. Then for two, we have di. The name of group is methyl. Okay. And we have 4 carbon here in main chain. This is the main chain. So for 4 carbon, we are using again but all the carbon-carbon single bond. So we are using ANE. So 2,2-dimethylbutane is the IUPAC name, okay? But we have total number of carbon here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is neohexane. Neohexane, okay?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
this sir. Is another branch chain hydrocarbon. So I hope you have understood neo and iso, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Okay, again, take a screenshot for that first. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here also for neoalkanes. So don't forget about neo and isoalkanes. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so let me check what is the time now. We'll understand first very quickly about the branch, cyclic chain, third one, ring chain or closed or cyclic. Okay, suppose we have three carbon chain, CH3, CH2 and CH3. Suppose I am writing it like this, CH3, CH2 and here CH3. Instead of here CH3, I'm just writing CH2 and here one hydrogen, here also CH2 and one hydrogen. So I'm just removing that two hydrogen atom from the terminal carbon. Okay, so now what we will get? We will get CH2 double bond, single bond CH2, here CH2 and here also. So this is the cyclic structure. So we are using cyclopropane for that. Cyclopropane. See, cyclopropane.
So what happens to the two hydrogens you remove?
It has been removed out by the catalyst or any reaction, dehydrogenation reaction.
So will there be a double bond between them to make up?
There is possibilities for double bond also, but possibility for the cyclic chain also.
So cyclic chain doesn't have to complete its octet?
Terminal carbon atom we are discussing about here. So carbon sharing one carbon electron with that carbon, okay, and two with other hydrogen atom, is it? And here one carbon, yes. So last pair, again, they are sharing over here. That's why they are bonded with terminal carbon, first and last carbon, means terminal carbon atom, they are sharing pair of electron by removal of hydrogen gas. And they form the cyclic structure. Okay, see here, now their octet is complete here. So carbon, here we have carbon, here we have carbon, and here two hydrogen, here two hydrogen, here two hydrogen. Octet is completed now. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when terminal carbon atom of hydrocarbon are attached with each other, they form ring or closed cyclic structure. Closed or cyclic structure, okay, are called as cyclic or ring or closed hydrocarbon. Okay? Okay, everyone? Everyone understood? Everyone understood that?
Sir?
Understood?